Welcome to iNurture Videos. In this video, we'll describe about free consent in a contract. After going through this video, you must be able to explain details about free consent in the contract. Let's first understand the meaning of consent. Consent means matching of minds. Two or more persons are said to be in a consent when they agree upon the same thing in the same sense. Free consent is one of the essential elements of a valid contract. A contract must be formed by free consent of both the parties involved in the contract to the terms of the agreement. Next, let's look at the elements that make a consent to be free. A consent is said to be free when it is not caused by coercion or undue influence or fraud or misrepresentation. Next, let's discuss each one of them in detail. In Section 15 of the Indian Contract Act defines coercion is committing or threatening to commit any act forbidden by the Indian Penal Code or the unlawful detaining or threatening to detain any property or to the prejudice of any person, whatever with the intention of causing the person to enter into an agreement. Thus, coercion can be referred as committing an act with the purpose to compel the other person to agree to the terms of a contract. Next, let's see the example of a coercion. For example, assume Ram threatens to kill Anand's son if the latter refuses to sell his house to him at a throwaway price. Such sale would be regarded as a void at the option of Anand, as he was forced to perform the deed. Section 71 states that anything received due to coercion must be repaid or returned. Next, let's look at undue. According to Section 16(1) of the Contract Act, a contract is said to be induced by an undue influence where the relations subsisting between the parties are such that one of the parties is in a position to dominate the will of the other and uses the position to obtain unfair advantage over the other. Next, let's look at constitutes of undue influence. The term undue influence means dominating the will of the other person to obtain an unfair advantage over the other, where the relations between the parties are such that one of them is in a position to dominate the will of the other. The dominant party uses that position to obtain an unfair advantage over the other. Next, let's look at the term fraud. According to the Section 17, fraud means and includes any of the following acts committed by a party to a contract or with his conveyance or by his agent with the intent to deceive another party thereto or his agent or to induce him to enter into a contract. Any act is to be fraud if any of the following acts have been committed by a party to induce the other into a contract shall be regarded as fraud. The suggestion as a fact of that which is not true by one who himself does not believe it to be true. Concealment of facts, making a promise without any intention of keeping it. Any deceiving act. Any act or omission prescribed by the law as fraudulent activity. Next, let's look at misrepresentation. It must be material fact. The misrepresentation must be false, but the person making it honestly believe it to be true. Let's summarize our learnings. The summary of the tutorial on free consent in a contract has been put on the screen. I'll pause for a few seconds to allow you to read it. Thank you for watching the video. Have a nice day.